Hello, we're going to talk about CAA today. Stroke tips is for medical professionals. We provide useful information within a few minutes. For intracerebral hemorrhage means bleeding inside the brain tissue. There are two main types. Hypertensive bleed tends to occur in basal ganglia or the deep part of the brain. Cerebral amyloid angiopathy tends to cause a lobar hemorrhage close to the surface of the brain. Let's take a look at this CT scan. Lobar hemorrhage, meaning the bleeding is close to the cortex or subcortical white matter. Cerebral amyloid angiopathy, overview. It is caused by amyloid deposits in small and medium-sized blood vessels. It's rare before 60 years old. By autopsy, it's present in about 12% over 85 years old. Clinically, patient may present with a lobar hemorrhage. Transient focal neurological event may be caused by small bleeding. And to make a clinical diagnosis, patient usually over 55 years old, hemorrhage at lobar, cortical, or subcortical area. It tends to be multiple, or it may be single bleeding plus old or recent disseminated small bleeding. And there's no other cause of hemorrhage was found. But definitive diagnosis can only be made postmortem. Let's look at this diagram, and on the left upper corner is the cortical superficial siderosis, means old deposit of iron. On the right upper corner, there may be small subarachnoid hemorrhage, and the left lower corner, patient may have a larger lobar intracerebral hemorrhage, and in the right lower corner, it shows possible small old small bleeding. And these small bleedings can be in combination of in any combination, and that would help to make us the diagnosis of the CAA. MRI scan T2 or SWI may show some old small hemorrhages, and it's good practice to follow up an MRI scan in about 3 months to exclude other causes of the bleeding. Treatment for the acute stage is same as other intracerebral hemorrhage. Long term, we try to avoid any antiplatelet anticoagulant, as patient has over 20% chance of recurrent bleeding at 2 years, and they also have a higher chance of dementia. Well, most of these information are from British Medical Journal. Thank you for your attention. We'll see you next time. Bye.